Creatine is one of the most studied supplements on the planet. I recommend it all the time. I recommend it to family members. And yet, I've personally never taken it, and I might never take it over my lifetime. And I don't think there's any contradiction there, because all of these decisions, every medication, every supplement, every food, everything in life really hinges on risk-benefit. And the risk and the benefit determination depends. It varies person to person. So in this video, I want to go over the proven benefits of creatine and then potential risks so that you can make an informed decision that works for you. And I don't sell creatine. I don't have a connection to any company that does. This is the good thing about turning down every sponsor and not selling any products. When something like this comes up, we can look at the data objectively, and I'm very comfortable. I have no conflict of interests. So what are the benefits of supplementing creatine? Well, there's actually quite a few. First, creatine helps you build muscle and lose fat. So you get results from your workouts faster. A systematic review and meta-analysis of randomized trials found that creatine supplementation increased fat-free mass by an average of 0.8 kilos, while at the same time reducing body fat percentage by roughly 0.28%. And most trials last from a few days to a couple months. So these benefits would probably accrue over time. And when people did resistance training at the same time as they were supplementing, working out, pushing their muscles to the limit, then the results, the effect of creatine were even stronger. Creatine also helps you increase your strength. And this is seen even in older adults and even in people who have muscle conditions like muscle dystrophies. If you are vegetarian or vegan, you may benefit even more from creatine because your diet naturally contains less of it. Creatine is richest in animal products like meat or seafood. Number two, creatine also helps you perform and recover faster. When we exercise, when we push our muscles to the limit, it creates micro tears in muscle tissue. And as those micro tears heal, that makes the muscle stronger, and that's what causes hypertrophy, the growth of muscle tissue. Creatine can activate special cells in muscle tissue that help heal those micro tears and accelerate your recovery. In fact, most creatine we take goes straight to your muscles. It's broken down there, and it can help fuel and re-energize your muscle tissue. But it's not just the body, it's not just your brawn, it's also your brain. Some evidence indicates that creatine can help improve your short-term memory, your reasoning, attention, and information processing speed. This effect is seen more often in older individuals. I've seen a couple trials in younger individuals reporting a benefit. It's just less common, and the magnitude of the effect is less impressive. It can still work in younger people. For example, under conditions of stress, if the participants are sleep deprived, for example. So this suggests that creatine is not making you superhuman, but it's supporting your brain activity. One proposed mechanism for how creatine has this effect is that it helps provide energy to your neurons in the form of ATP molecules, and our neurons are very energy consuming. And younger adults normally have higher creatine levels, so it makes sense that we see a smaller benefit. Whereas in older adults or in people under different stress conditions, you have lower levels of creatine and lower mitochondrial efficiency as well. So the supplementation makes a bigger difference. Number four, this one is less well known, but creatine may also help control your blood sugar. A randomized trial found that diabetics receiving creatine supplementation lowered their glycated hemoglobin, their hemoglobin A1C, and their blood sugar levels after a meal. And last but not least, creatine is very cheap. It comes down to a couple dollars a month if you supplement daily. So that's a ton of benefits, quite impressive. What's the downside? What's the risk? Well, one of the main concerns with creatine supplementation is kidney safety, and that's for a couple reasons. One reason is that one way we measure kidney function and kidney health is by measuring the levels of this thing called creatinine. Normally, our kidneys excrete creatinine, and so when our kidneys are not functioning normally, when there's some issue or kidney disease, kidney insufficiency, kidney failure, creatinine levels go up. But when we take creatine, some of it gets converted to creatinine, and so the levels of creatinine are artificially raised in the blood, and so that can look like a kidney issue. There's also a concern that excreting that extra creatinine might be an extra burden on your kidneys and over time may damage them or harm them somehow. So this has been studied pretty extensively and mostly points to safety. Multiple studies varying in duration from 5 days all the way to 5 years, and varying in dose of creatine supplementation from 5 all the way to 30 grams a day, they have shown no measurable effect on indices of kidney function, things like glomerular filtration rate, GFR. So this is one measure of kidney function. The glomerulus is the functional unit of the kidney, and the speed at which it's filtering your blood and producing urine is one measure of whether your kidneys are functioning properly or not. So they don't see a decline in these studies. Now, they do note that this is in healthy individuals with no pre-existing kidney disease. So overall, I think the risk-benefit for healthy people is quite favorable, especially older individuals and for people who work out. Those populations are likely to benefit the most. Now, in my case, we have a kidney disease that runs in my family. It's genetically inherited. It's polycystic kidney, or PKD. And this basically causes these little cysts, these little bubbles of liquid, of fluid, to grow in your kidneys very slowly over the years. And it's asymptomatic for most of your life. And then eventually when you get to 60 or 70, it varies. But usually in your later years, it causes your kidneys to malfunction and you eventually need dialysis or a transplant. And understandably, we have a lot less data on the safety of creatine supplementation in individuals who have some kidney disease, specifically on polycystic kidney. We have no data as far as I know. So that changes the risk-benefit determination, because I don't know. There's no way for me to know if creatine in the long run is gonna damage a kidney that already has an underlying issue, if it's gonna accelerate the demise of the kidney or cause some problem. And the benefits of creatine, I can mostly get them some other way. So one benefit is accelerating results in the gym, growing muscle a little faster and losing fat a little faster. Well, I can just work harder and get the same result 6 months or a year later. It can assist cognitive function later in life. So right now I probably see little to no benefit, especially if I'm not under stress. So I'm very careful with sleep and rest and diet and exercise and lifestyle. And then the glucose control, well, I can do that with lifestyle, with careful diet and exercise. I can manage fasting glucose and hemoglobin A1C. So my strategy personally, you can see this is very personal, is to play it safe until we know more about creatine supplementation, specifically in a population that has kidney issues. And this is a pretty specific population, so we may never get those data. So it might never be worth it for me. But for most people without kidney issues, I think the risk benefit is pretty favorable. The benefits are impressive, and I think it's worth considering it. What about supplements to support a healthy aging? We covered all of that in this previous video. Check it out. I'll meet you in there.